Good morning, church. How are you doing this morning? I hope that means you're doing good. Let's stand, please, together as we begin to worship the Lord. As we are brought into fellowship of the King, we are called friends of God. So that's something we're going to celebrate this morning. So through your mask, I want to hear those voices sing. Let's lift him up this morning.
Who am I that you are mindful of me? That you hear me when I call? And is it true that you are thinking of me? How you love me? It's amazing.
I got to give this word to you today. Jesus says, greater love hath no one than this, than one lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends. What a good word today. Welcome to Walter Hill First Baptist Church, here in the building and out yonder in yonder land. And it's good to see everybody here. And you know what? We've got a great vaccine coming that 2 or 3 or 4 months from now, this will be something we'll talk about. But we've also got Jesus on the cross, who has become the vaccine for all of our pain and problems. And I want to tell you something. One day, we're going to be in heaven, and they don't even know what a mask is in heaven. So isn't that going to be a good day? Glory! Yeah! Amen. But, you know, we have an opportunity to talk to the one who created us through Jesus Christ. And let's pray that his spirit will come fill us, he will magnify his word, and he will lift up our hearts as we worship him and adore him today. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for this morning. We pray, Lord, that you'll minister to our hearts. Lord, as our needs are, may your strength be given to us. Your grace strengthen us today. Lord, as we sing, as we pray, as we preach, as we listen, Holy Spirit, may you wrap your arms around us, whether we're in this building or watching out there in our homes or wherever we might be, to know you are with us. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. And God's people said, amen. Amen. As we continue to sing, this next song is a blessing. Have faith in God. Let's do that.
Trust in the Lord.
He leadeth me, O blessed thought, O words with heavenly comfort fraught. Whatever I do, whatever I be, still 'tis God's hand that leadeth me. Thank you.
God, I'm going to ask if you will lead us in prayer here in just a minute. Thank you. You know, I appreciate so much our leaders here at this church and our deacons. You know, once a month we get together on Zoom and we spend an hour and a half talking about the needs of our church and how we can proceed and move forward with that. And, you know, although sometimes you get held back, you keep moving for the Lord, don't you? You know, and Patty, I know you're excited about seeing the things that are taking place on our media center. We're going to get a new floor on it now, and we've got new lights that are being installed, and we just voted to get a new computer. We've got a computer as slow as Christmas. You know, that's a whole 12 months ever slow, right? And finally, we're going to get something that we can use that's going to be more up to where we need to be there. And you voted this week, and thank you so much for everybody. But I want to tell you something. It's because of God's goodness and His grace that we do so good. And also because of your faithfulness. I want to thank everyone who continues to give. You might not have been able to be here, but you've been faithful. And we have things to celebrate. Avon was 80 years old now with Ike. 80 years old. Can you believe that? Oh, my goodness. We're excited about that. And other things, Miss Padilla, Lydia Padilla, had cancer surgery this week. So we need to pray for her and for good results to come from that. And there's so many that are on our prayer list. How about you? You got something on your heart? You say, Lord, please remember me in this or that. Amen. Okay. And how many of us today would say, I have so much to be grateful for to the Lord? Amen. Amen. And we've got some that got COVID. You know, we got Blake and we've got Christian, and we got others that are being tested and still waiting for some results. So we're just going to make it through this thing, aren't we? If the leaves keep falling, we're going to keep chopping them up. That's just what we're going to do. All right. Well, right now, as we go to the Lord in prayer, let's pray. Brother Todd, lead us, please.
Father, thank you for this day, Lord. Thank you for the sunshine after the storms this morning, Lord. Thank you for seeing each one of us through those overnight, Lord. And again, thank you for the sunshine this morning, Lord, as a reminder that you're a good God. Father, that you will always see us through the storm, Lord. Even though when we're in the midst, Father, and we're surrounded by the wind, the rain, the thunder and lightning, Father, you're above it all, Lord, and you see the outcome and the other side. Father, again, thank you for the celebrations that we had this week, Lord. We celebrate recovery for those that have been afflicted by this COVID, Lord, those that have gone through surgery and come out of surgery, Father, and continue to give them strength as they'll go through rehab and recovery, Father. Be with our pastor, Lord, as he brings your message this morning. Father, I pray that we are all good stewards. Lord, that we have open hearts, open ears, and open minds to receive what you have to tell us this morning. Lord, thank you again for leading us. Continue to be with us, Lord, as we bring praise to you this morning. Father, and be with us when we go our separate ways. Jesus, thank you for loving us. Thank you for bearing the cross for each and every one of us. It's in your name I pray. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated, church, if you feel led to remain standing. Just know that at any time, if you want to stand in the presence of the Lord and worship Him, you do that. If you need to be seated, you be seated. My concern as a worship minister is just that your heart is zeroed in on the presence of God here in this place. Tell you what, I think about this days we're living in and this old frail body that we have and the sickness that just pervades us. And you know, we do what we can outwardly to protect this frail body. We wear our mask, we use our hand sanitizer, and you know, quite frankly, that's what my son has been doing, even when he tested positive a couple of weeks ago. He's been a trooper, he's stayed in his room, and the rest of us have tested negative, which we praise the Lord for. But you know, it just goes to show you that our hope is not in this world. We may and we will get sick. If it's not this, it'll be something else. We all have these obstacles that we face in our life, but you know, when we push all of these things away that are just temporary, even this old body of clay, We know that our spirit is eternal. And so today we don't so much concern ourselves with COVID in this place as much as our spiritual health. Where are you in your relationship with the Lord? Can you truly echo the cries and say, the Lord gives, the Lord takes away, but nevertheless, blessed be the name of the Lord, that we're going to praise Him when we're pressed. We're going to lift Him up when we feel crushed. That's what this song is about. So let's just honor Him. Let's sing this to Him. Father, we love You. We thank You for Your presence in this place. And Father, may Your name be lifted high.
You give life. You are love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope. You restore every heart that is broken. And great are You, Lord. It's Your breath in our lungs, so we
in this next song.
Worthy of the song we could ever sing. Worthy of
praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe, we live for you.
His name is Jesus. Let's sing.
Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever say, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe, we live for you, we live for you. Holy, there is no one like you, there is none beside you.
This morning, our life, Lord, is built on you.
And I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation. I will put my trust in you alone. And I will not be shaken.
Song. Thank you, praise team, so much for leading us in that. And you know, I want to just say thank you to each one who's been praying for Debbie. Years working as a nurse. It used to be in the good old days they'd have helpers come in and help you turn a patient to bathe them, and even at St. Thomas. And then they began to pull back, and then the charge nurse would help the nurses turn a patient. Then they started giving charge nurses a full load, and then the nurse themselves find themselves alone turning patients, sometimes were as many as 400 pounds. And over the years, this has hurt many of our nurses, including Debbie, and so she's hurting now with the stenosis of her her spinal cord, and so we just pray for you. And as I'm thinking about you, sweetheart, and I'm thinking of all of us who have put ourselves in harm's way to serve others. Veterans Day was this week, and we want to have a little presentation right now. But you know, I want to also include our first responders, firemen, medical staff, all the others who put themselves in a place of service, but also in harm's way to care for others. Now, I did what I said. I said, put pictures on Facebook. I'll find them and stick them in there. And so I went through Facebook just about every other day, as far as I could, until I got tired of looking at Facebook. And I found some pictures here. But I want us to take a moment to remember not just those who have served in the past, but those that are serving today, or those that have served that are still with us today. But before I flip the next switch and get this going, let's thank the Lord for Jesus, who gave himself. He's the greatest veteran of all time. Let's pray. Lord, I just thank you for each one that has sacrificed in some way themselves to be of service for the freedom and the watch care of others. Bless them, Lord, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.